This you're looking at is the crew of the SpaceX Dragon capsule, set to be welcomed aboard the International Space Station by the current crew members any moment now. The SpaceX crew took off from Kennedy Space Center early Friday. They spent nearly 24 hours soaring through orbit at more than 17,000 miles per hour just to catch up to the ISS.
Yeah, the four astronauts are going to live on the ISS for the next 6 months. So as we take a look at these live pictures, let's bring in CNN Business Innovation and Space Correspondent Rachel Crane. And we also have with us retired NASA astronaut Leroy Chiao. Thank you for joining us, Leroy. But Rachel, let's start with you. Walk us through the history here. This is a historic moment, in part because SpaceX is reusing hardware that they used in the past, and that's a big step toward space exploration for the United States, isn't it?
That's exactly right, Boris. I mean, it's hard to overemphasize how important reusability is in terms of driving down the cost of space exploration to, you know, hopefully one day be able to put boots on Mars, return us to the moon. It's going to be pretty costly, so you don't want this one and done, you know, space flight of the past in terms of the hardware. And SpaceX had reused their boosters many times before, but never on a crewed flight. I'm talking about the first stage booster of the Falcon 9. So they had to put that booster through many, many checks, thousands of checks, including the spacecraft Endeavour. Endeavour, the spacecraft that Crew 2 flew on, this is actually, it's returning to the space station. It's already been there. It flew Bob Behnken and Doug Hurley nearly a year ago on that maiden voyage of Crew Dragon to the International Space Station with a crew on board. So, you know, a really historic moment here that SpaceX has really been able to crack the nut on the reusability in terms of these crewed missions, all in an effort to continue to drive down the cost of space exploration. But Elon Musk also making the point that it actually might be safer to fly flight-proven hardware because you know it's already been put through the paces, you know it's already working. It was interesting also to see yesterday at the launch that the Falcon 9 booster had soot and scorch marks all over it. SpaceX,
Rachel,
you know, choosing to wear...
I don't want to interrupt you, just want to let you know that right now the astronauts aboard the SpaceX capsule are actually entering the ISS. It appears that Thomas Pesquet, Akiko Hoshide have entered, and there is Megan MacArthur. She's a pilot from California. Her husband actually is Bob Behnken, who Rachel just mentioned. To you, Leroy, what do you think watching this, having been there before, having been one of the astronauts who helped build the ISS as it is today?
Actually, hold on a second. Can we listen? Can we listen real quickly to see if we can hear what they're saying?
The 11-person crew of Expedition 65 now together inside Node 2 of the International Space Station.
Okay, I guess that's all we get to hear, but go ahead. Go ahead, Rachel.
We can't even hear audio.
Well, you know, right now, this is the moment they've all been waiting for, you know, this the arrival, the safe arrival, you know, most importantly, of Crew 2 on the International Space Station. There were 7 crew members on board station. So now with the arrival, there's 11 of them. This is the moment, you know, where there these congratulatory hugs. As you can see, you know, everyone is very joyous here. This is a big, big moment. We're going to see an official welcoming ceremony coming up. But, you know, this is the moment where the families of these astronauts can take a little bit of a sigh of relief that they are safely on board. And as I pointed out, you know, it's a little crowded on board station. It'll only be for a few days. Crew 1 will be departing station in just a couple of days. But this welcoming ceremony should be happening any minute. And this is something that they do when any crew arrives. But, you know, this is a really an important one because this passing of the baton of Crew 1 to Crew 2, you know, is quite special.
Yeah, Leroy, I know that you have done this because you spent 6 months serving as the International Space Station commander back in 2004 and 2005. I don't know what that is, but I want to try to see if we can get back to the live pictures of them because we saw them all get in their respective places and they have a microphone in their hand, so they are going to be speaking and we're going to be waiting to see that happen. But Leroy, talk to us about what it's like to be a new member of the ISS when you first got there and you had that welcoming ceremony. I mean, did you feel an immediate sense of camaraderie with the people who were already there?
Well, absolutely. We all know each other very well from our training. We've trained together and we've known each other for a long time. And so getting on board is a great feeling because that means your mission is going to go. In other words, if your docking had failed and you had to return to Earth and all that training that you went through, that all kind of gets put on hold. So getting the hatches open and coming on board and the excitement of starting your own expedition is really special. So these folks are very happy, obviously, this is, I believe, a record number of people we have on the station at one time. And so a lot of firsts in this mission, including, as was discussed, the first usage of a recycled or refurbished spacecraft and a refurbished first stage rocket for a flight with astronauts on board.
I understand that it took the Dragon spacecraft to align itself with the docking ports and parked itself, and all of those maneuvers were directed by computer. I mean, everybody's obviously comfortable with that, but who's at the ready to fix it if something happens, Leroy?
Oh, absolutely, yeah. No, the docking procedure is automated, just as it is for the Russian Soyuz, and the crew is the backup. The crew is monitoring everything very carefully, and they're ready to take over manual control. In fact, during my approach and docking in the Soyuz spacecraft, we had an emergency under 200 meters. It was actually pretty dangerous. Our autopilot failed and started speeding us up instead of slowing us down, and also started a left rotation, so we started losing sight of the station, and we actually did have to take manual control and complete the docking manually.
Yikes. Well, we're glad you're okay, Leroy. Rachel, I wanted to ask you, because you mentioned future space exploration and a mission perhaps to Mars. The ISS at this point is actually old enough to drink. It's 21 years old. What is its role going to be moving forward for the United States specifically in heading to Mars?
Yeah, well, the International Space Station, it's important to remember, is a national laboratory. So a ton of science and research is being conducted on the International Space Station right now in that effort to return us to the moon, the Artemis mission, and then eventually to get us to Mars. So, it's an incredibly important stepping stone and vehicle with which to get us on these deeper space journeys. And the future of the space station is a little bit in limbo right now. It does have, it is going to have to be retired at some point, or they're going to have to update it because, as you pointed out, it's old enough to drink at this point. Whether it's going to be another commercial space station that will replace it, all of that is yet to be determined. But what we do know is that there's an incredible amount of important research being conducted right now and will continue for the foreseeable future to help us to get back to the moon and, hopefully in our lifetime. Time, Boris, get us to Mars.
Rachel Crane and Leroy Chow. Go ahead, Leroy, what did you want to say?
Oh, I was going to say, actually, the space station, I think, is an important and critical part of the exploration program because it serves as a test bed, not only for hardware that we will put on a spacecraft to go to Mars, but also for a biomedical test bed to develop these, what we call countermeasures. It turns out that space is pretty harsh on the human body and all living systems, and we need to figure out how we're going to keep these crews healthy on a journey to Mars and back. And the space station provides us with that test bed in addition to all the physiological research that's going on.
Oh, yeah. I mean, the toughness of all of these people, of you, Leroy, who has been there and done that. We see all of them standing there together for the first time now as they are all in space. And on Wednesday, we know those crews are going to flip, and the crew that has been there for 6 months is going to come home. Rachel Crane and Leroy Chow, thank you both so much for walking us through what we're watching today.
Thanks.
Pleasure. Thanks.